my dear followers, and welcome back. We're gonna be doing our exercises and our classes now in a new online format, so I'm going to do my best to break it down for you and keep you busy for the next whatever amount of time. I'm going to start first from the exercises that will help you stretch and get your body warmed up, and after that I'm going to give you three more exercises for women's technique, followers technique, that you can do at home by yourself, either following the video or after watching the video, you can practice it on your own. So let's start our first set of exercises. For that, you are going to need to use a stick. So go ahead and grab a stick. Also, I'm going to do the first set of exercises barefoot. Put your feet shoulder width apart. Slightly soften your legs. Don't lock them up, don't keep them straight. Shoulders down, tailbone slightly tilted down and relaxed. Grab a stick slightly wider than the shoulder width. Now, bring your shoulders to align them with the ribcage. So now I'd like for you to see how this exercise would look from the side. As you can see, my elbows are aligned with my ribcage. My pelvis is slightly tilted downwards. I am not arching my back. Make sure you're not arching your back. And your shoulders are relaxed. Now, from this position, on the count of four, we're going to start dissociating towards our right on four counts. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we're gonna come back to the neutral on the next set of four counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. The same thing we're gonna do to our left. 1, 2, 3, 4. Check in with our hips and make sure they're not moving. And come back to the neutral. 1, 2, 3, 4. Remember, on counts of four. And 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now let's work together. And 1, 2, 3, hold. 1, 2, 3, hold. The other side. 1, 2, 3, hold. 1, 2, 3, hold. Repeat this exercise 3 times on one side and 3 times on the other. For the next exercise, we're going to move our stick behind our back. I'm going to turn around so you can see it. Align the stick with the line, with the bra line, and release your shoulder blades down, like so. 1, 2, 3, hold. 1, 2, 3, hold. 1, 2, 3, hold. Make sure your hips are not moving, and let's go back. 1, 2, 3, hold. Now we're gonna repeat this exercise 3 times on each side as well. The next exercise, we're gonna use the same position of the stick and we're gonna go forward and come back up again. Ready? Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Make sure your head is up and not down. Let's go back up. 1, 2, 3, 4. One more time. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So the next set of exercises, we're going to work on our legs, so waist down. Place your weight on the left foot and your free leg is gonna do the exercises. Make sure your hands are on your hips, slightly pushing down, ribcage up to separate your ribcage from your hips. Ready? So now we're gonna point forward, side, back, collect together, and transfer our weight. Point forward, side, back, collect together, and transfer our weight. Next, we're gonna connect all the points and do it one full lattice. 1, 2, 3, collect, and change your weight. 1, 2, 3, collect, and change your weight. Repeat each exercise 3 times. Thank you. Now we're going to move on to our drills. So the drills are going to be done on our heels. The purpose of the next drill is a walking drill. I would like you to focus on balance, being grounded, and the technique of pivoting, where we're gonna use the dissociation technique that we practiced in the earlier exercise. I'm going to break down and brush up on the technique of a step. So, change our weight onto the left foot. In a practice embrace, shoulders down, ribcage up. We're going to start by pointing the free leg forward. Now, we're going to shift our weight, so we're split weight, 50-50 on each leg. We're going to activate inner thighs and push off using the back leg to transfer the weight onto the forward leg, fully transferring your weight, slightly softening your legs to brush through the center to transition to the next step. Again, pointing forward, split weight, activate your thighs, transfer weight using the pushing off of the back leg, brush through the center into the next step. What do you need to know to do a successful pivot? First, we need to completely transfer our weight onto our standing leg. Second, the pivot initiates with the upper body, with the torso, in a spiral where the torso goes first, hips follow, knees follow, at the end, ankles, with the ankles together. So we're going to initiate the pivot with torso, hips, knees, and ankles, transitioning to the next step. Next step. Again, full transfer of weight first, starting with our torso and ankles together. Full transfer of the weight into the pivot. Exercise with the music. First, let's listen to the music and find our single beat. So I'm snapping my fingers on a heavy beat. We can move on to the next level of difficulties, and after the pivot we're going to go into the low forward ballet. So it will look something like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So at the very end, after the pivot, we're gonna go into the low forward ballet. Ready? Let's do it together. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So the next exercise, we're going to start facing diagonal. We're going to step diagonal back, starting with your left foot. Back, side, forward, collect. Now diagonal step back with the right foot. Back, side, forward, collect. When we do these steps, let's not forget about our torso. On the back steps, we dissociate. On the side step, we become neutral. And on the forward step, we dissociate. Same ideas here. Back, dissociate, side, neutral. Forward, dissociate. Now let's do it with a count. And One, two, three, collect. One, two, three, collect. Now we're gonna move on to the next level of difficulties, doing exact same exercise, only at the end we're going to do high forward balayage. Starting with the left foot back, we're gonna step. We're going to step back, side, forward. Now with our right foot, we're going to do forward high balayage and collect together. Now stepping back with our right foot, back, side, forward, now using our left for the high boleo, collect together. Now let's do it with a count. And one, two, three, boleo. One, two, three, boleo. Together with a count. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. So now I'm going to break down how to do a forward high balayage. Pretend that you have a piece of paper under your big toe of a free leg. Now I'm going to trace the big toe around my standing foot and send my foot up as if I'm pushing the paper back. For the ladies, try to point all your toes and also aim for the opposite thigh. So let's do it a couple of times. Trace and send the paper. One more time. Trace and aim for your thigh. The same thing with another leg. So now I'm going to use my right leg as my free leg. So I'm gonna pretend that I have a piece of paper under my right toe. I'm going to trace my standing foot and send the paper back. One more time. You're gonna aim for your left thigh. So trace your standing foot and send your paper up. The next exercise or drill will be the diagonal forward ochos and diagonal backward ochos. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Same exercise as we did forward diagonal ochos, now we're going to do back diagonal ochos. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Now let's break it down. While our hips and our feet are facing the direction of where we're gonna step, our torso dissociates and looks forward. After we've done forward step, make sure you completely transfer your weight. And then the same idea of a pivot as we have covered before, starting with the torso, ankles together. Step forward, full transfer of weight, starting with the torso, ankles together. Going diagonally backwards. Our torso again dissociated and facing forward. Our hips and our legs are gonna step diagonally back. So once we have committed to the step, make sure you transfer your weight fully first, starting with the torso, torso to initiate pivot, going backwards. Again, diagonal step back, full transfer weight with the torso initiating the pivot backwards. If you feel like you have a pretty good balance, you can do this exercise in a faster pace. However, if you feel like you're losing your balance and still don't have controlled steps, try to do it as slow as possible. So we're starting the exercise facing diagonally. Now, let's get into the frame and dissociate. So we're our torso is facing forward while our hips and feet in a step in the direction of the step. Now let's do the exercise in real time. One, pivot. Two, pivot. Three, pivot. Four, pivot. Now let's reverse and go backwards. Pivot, step. Pivot, step. Pivot, step. Pivot, step. So now this exercise is going to be next level of difficulties to what I just have shown you. Let's start again facing diagonally into the embrace, dissociate your torso forward. Now, after the forward step, what we're going to do is we're gonna tap lightly back foot, and as you pivot, collect. Step, tap lightly your foot, and as you pivot, collect. Make sure on the tap you keep your knees together. Step, knees together, tap, and as you pivot, collect. Step, knees together, tap, and as you pivot, collect. So now we're gonna do the same exercise going backwards, but next level of difficulties. As we step back with our left foot, we're going to do a high ball air with our right foot before pivoting, bringing your feet together and pivot. Step back with your right foot, your left foot is gonna do high ball air, pivot, completing the pivot and keeping your ankles together. So now we're gonna do it in a real time. Let's start facing diagonally, hips together, feet together. Now get into the embrace and dissociate so that your torso is facing forward. Now you're gonna step with our left foot first. And so when we do it musically, we're gonna do this exercise on a half time. So it's going to look something like this. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Same idea going backwards. We're gonna dance again on a half timing. So it will be one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. So thank you very much for your time. I hope you are going to do these exercises on a regular basis. I'm saying in the video, do it 3-4 times, but you're welcome to do it more repetitions and as often as you'd like. And we will see you soon in the next video. Lovely to see you.